So, Rosemarie, looking back on your first year as an MP, I know you're coming up on your 1 year this December. Mm-hmm. Tell me, what are some of the biggest challenges that you've faced?
I think some of the biggest challenges is the riding is so big, right? Like, we are down to Colville, just north of Kindersley, and all the way up to St. Walburg, and then on the other side of North Battleford on the east side. So I think one of the biggest challenges is trying to get everywhere in my time that I'm here in the riding to hear what constituents have to say.
Which is really important to your job, like understanding what constituents want and representing them properly. And so that's really admirable that you're committed to that. Now, also looking back, can you tell me what you feel some of your biggest successes were?
Biggest successes. So I had the opportunity to sit on the Human Resources Committee. We get a lot of legislation that comes in. I've had the opportunity to have input on that. Also, too, this summer I did do a summer tour of the riding. I don't want to say all the communities, but most of the communities, listening to what the concerns are of the communities at a municipal level, and also organizations that were affected by the Canada Summer Jobs Attestation.
What were some of the biggest concerns that you've heard from constituents when you did that?
Common themes are the failures of this government. A lot of our constituents want to be able to live affordably, and under this Prime Minister, that's very difficult. 81% of middle-class families have actually had an increased tax hike, so they're paying $861 more a year under this Prime Minister. So people are finding that life is getting very expensive, and especially with a carbon tax, the provincial government, Premier Scott Moe, is refusing to sign on to the carbon tax because that's what the people of Saskatchewan want. And it's very unfortunate to see the Prime Minister dictating to the provinces what needs to be done.
Now, looking ahead into 2019 and the election that comes this fall, what are you planning on, and what are you looking forward to the most?
I'm looking forward to connecting with constituents. We need to hear their concerns. We know what is important to them, right? A thriving economy, a sustainable environment, an environment that we can protect, and, for example, pipelines. Like, these are things that are important. Our ag farmers, even earlier this year, we saw the backlog of rail cars. That's an issue that needs to be addressed, which I believe we can address if we had pipelines. Take more oil off the rail, put more grain on the rail.
Now, looking ahead to, I guess, the Christmas season, it is like a time where people just feel thankful for a lot of things in their lives. Can you tell me a little bit about what you're thankful for?
What I'm thankful for? I am so thankful for my husband and my children and my family. I'm fortunate that my parents live in Lloydminster as well, so it's great to have them around and help out with the kids. But I'm also very grateful to have the opportunity to serve the constituents of Battleford's Lloydminster.
Wow, that's fantastic. Is there anything else you have to say about what you're looking forward to in the coming year?
I'm looking forward to a change in government in 2019. I'm looking forward to getting out, hitting the doors, and hearing what constituents have to say and what's important and what's affecting their families.
Thank you so much. And thank you for making the time to be here with us today. This has been an interview with Battleford's MP, Rosemarie Falk. Thank you.